Now, in some New Zealand cities, overseas buyers are buying up so much of the residential property that house prices have gone through the roof, making housing unaffordable for young people. Familiar story? The difference between here and New Zealand is that in New Zealand, the government has done something about it. This summer, they banned non-nationals living overseas from buying property in their country in a bid to bring prices down. Maybe it's time our government did the same. In many of our cities, particularly in London, people from all over the world have been buying up properties as investments for years, and they are still doing it. In a lot of cases, they don't even buy the properties for anyone to live in, just to leave empty. Now, this might be a good investment, but it means that thousands of properties are sitting empty in Britain when everyone recognises that we have a serious housing shortage. It is truly the economics and politics of the madhouse, and it's time we did something about it.
Greg, you've given me an open goal. How many properties do you own?
How many do I own?
How many properties do you own? Yeah. How many of them are investment properties sitting empty, and how many are overseas?
I haven't got any overseas. Well, one in Ireland, which I use as a holiday home for us and for my family, and one here, so that's it.
OK, so you've only got, what, three properties?
Yeah.
OK, good luck
fine.
To. Good
luck. Have you got any properties overseas?
Yeah, sure I have, yeah.
Exactly.
72 at the last count.
I agree that Eaton Square in London is apparently known as Red Square because so many Russians have bought houses there. But I'm very worried about telling people they can't buy properties and they can't sell properties. I think that way Corbynomics lies. And, you know, next thing that happens, we're going to have a Labour government requisitioning my house and giving it to Syrian refugees. Please don't let's open this can.
I think you are making a
jump.
You
mean the ones that are already living with you in the basement?
Yeah, that's right. That's staff.
I think you're a slight exaggeration there. I think the argument goes, look, there are a fair number of new apartments, particularly in big cities. It's happened in London. It's happening in Manchester, that are just left empty.
Yeah, safe deposits in the sky.
They are just left empty. Now, we have a housing crisis in this country. Everybody accepts we've got a housing crisis. And let's just hear from Ben Harris-Quinney, who's the chairman of a think tank, who's got a quite interesting view on it.
This is something that has had a major inflationary effect on the London housing market. And in the case of foreign companies buying up properties particularly, because they tend to be quite stable investments, tend to offer a yield of between 5 and 10% per year, a lot of those properties are just being left empty.
I recently went round a new estate in East London, private estate, where I was there for other reasons, but I was talking to the people who developed it. And they said, I said, well, how many of these are sitting empty? And they said, oh, we've done really well. It's only 10%. Mm-hmm. So if it's something like 10% of all new properties being built in our big cities are actually being left empty, being bought by Chinese investors or Russian investors and being left empty, then
so
that
what
is...
What is your problem? Is it the properties are being left empty or is it that property prices are being inflated?
Well, it's both, isn't it? It's both.
So
the second is the cause of
the
first
demand.
Is the cause of the second.
So if I think of places like Cornwall, for example, where you've got
a lot
of
holiday,
people,
they're holiday homes by and large, which is a different.
Yeah, but people well, not the whole of Cornwall, Greg. You can't ride off an entire
of
county.
No,
but a lot of
some villages have almost 2/3 of the houses sitting empty half the year.
Yes, but a lot of them are holiday homes that, and actually the local authorities are trying to encourage people to go down to those holiday homes because they spend money.
Greg, when did banning ever cure anything?
Oh, I don't know. I think what we should do...
It's your word. Excuse me, sir.
No,
they should be banned.
No,
you're going dangerously to the right in your old age. You're now telling people what they should do with their money
you
and you're banning...
Right?
No,
I think that's to the right.
No,
I think that's to the left.
Well, to the left. Yeah, well, it's banning, though. This is going to be banned. It's very,
very
concerned
about it. No, what I'm saying is, if you found out that all the new houses... When I was chairman of Brentford Football Club and we were going to develop some new houses, I remember the estate agent coming along and said, you do understand 30% of these will be bought overseas. If you go and look at some of the big estates that have been built in recent times in central London, large
can we just get a grab a stat on that before we bring in Trevor, which is that 7% of residential sales in Greater London in 2013 were to non-UK residents, 20% of residential sales in inner London, prime London, was to foreign
residents.
I think that your accusation, Nick, is a bit unfair. We do tell people what they can do with their money. You cannot cash every bit of your pension in tomorrow. We've got rules about that because we know that if you have rules that allow people essentially to mess up the financial system, then we all suffer. And in this case, what Greg is really talking about is the fact that overseas, what they say is central London property is the best reserve currency in the world. It's the way to stash your cash. And I think, actually, that's causing a real problem for us, particularly in London.
Trevor, some of these are million-pound apartments.
Pardon?
Some of these are, like, million-pound
apartments. Yeah, but we know how the ripples... But we know it ripples down.
I hear what Greg says about getting on the ladder, but £1 million?
No, but... Yeah, but it's rippling all the way down in London to a point where no young person, even one who has a decent job earning 40, 50 grand a year, can afford to buy a home. And even though I doubt if this is going to have the massive effect, the housing market responds to signals, and this would be a big, fat signal to try at least to stop the escalation of prices.
I mean, the problem with it is, of course, is that if it starts bringing down prices, all of us who own houses in London will not like that.
That's why people don't like it.
Yeah, the real danger is people
I'd like it because my kids could afford somewhere to live.
They want cheaper houses for their kids, but they don't necessarily want the price of the value of their house to go down.
So do you have the same view about, because you're focusing all of this on overseas purchases, but then, so would you be OK if it was a UK landlord based in Hull that was buying up copious amounts of London properties?
If they're buying them up and leaving them empty, yeah, I've got a problem.
Oh.
Well, it's about be a very
ones,
bad
investment.
But that's
the
why I asked
the current market, where property prices are actually on the downward trend, that is a
But I asked
bad
you at
investment.
The beginning what your concern was. Is it that people are leaving them empty, or is it that... And you said it's both.
Well,
so
it's
then
both.
I said to you, OK, so if someone in Hull wants to buy up half of London and leave them empty because they want to invest, or just buy, is that OK? And you said, well, no, because then they'll be empty. So you're saying that if someone in Hull wants to buy up half of London, they can.
But that's not what's happening. What's happening is that people from overseas...
So if a rich Russian let these apartments, you're relaxed about that?
More relaxed than having a rich Russian buying them.
But isn't that a failure of the taxation system? Shouldn't those rich Russians be paying quadruple, ten times the council tax? There are other ways
you could do this. You could put a 20% surcharge on
if it's empty.
Anyone from overseas having an empty house. Yeah, there are other ways.
Well, we have
additional stamp duty, don't we, if you buy additional properties?
Yes.
You have an additional rate on that.
But that's small beer compared... Well, it's particularly, you know, since the Brexit vote, the pound has gone down, so it's actually got cheaper to buy here than it was 3 years ago.
I'm basically with Greg on this, but I have one slight worry. As one of the authors of the 2010 Equality Act, you'd have to change it, because actually you'd be discriminating
on the grounds
of nationality. And would there be a... I mean, I said about this is about signals. Would you be sending a signal that said, we're not that keen on foreigners, and does that worry you at all, Greg?
No, if that person is going to come and live here, that's fine. Wants to live in the flat, or they're going to let it... But the idea of as you're getting with companies, because house prices have continued to go up, you're getting companies buying whole blocks. Go on the train into, say, Waterloo, and just look out the window at night and see, in all those new blocks, how many lights there are.
See, we don't mind you saying it, Greg, but if Nigel Farage had said this, you know what the reaction would have been.
Well, sometimes Nigel Farage is right.